Hey friends, it's Jacqueline here. In today's video, I will be sharing with you those 5 skin-like foundations that will work great for those of us that we have dry, sensitive, and mature skin. But before we get started, and if you're new here, I hope that you will consider and subscribe to my channel, ring that post notification bell so you don't miss any of my uploads, and come and follow me on my Instagram. And now, if you want to see what are those 5 skin-like foundations, then just keep on watching. I hope you are having a beautiful day, my friends, that you are enjoying your holiday season. Another Vlogmas day, and I decided to share with you today those 5 foundations that they give that skin-like finish. And if you're new here, I think I mentioned it perhaps on my intro, I do have dry, sensitive skin, mature skin. I'm already over my 4th floor. I'm 40 years old, soon to be 41. I do have enlarged pores. I do have a few dry patches here and there, fine lines right here on my forehead, on my crossfeed, and yeah, signs of aging, you know? So what is a skin-like foundation? At least to me, I think it's one that, oh, something very important. I do have a lot of freckles. I do have a little bit of discoloration, some sunspots here and there. And to me, it's not to completely cover them, but actually to camouflage them. For me, a skin-like foundation, I think it has to preserve that kind of velvet finish that our skin has naturally. You know, it has to look, you know, as natural as possible, not super matte, not super glowy, not super dewy. And that can be a little bit tricky for me because as a person that has dry skin, I tend to lean more into those foundations that give me a dewy finish, you know, glowy finish, but not super dewy, not super glowy. But you know what? I also have those foundations that I gravitate towards kind of like in daily basis, that I know that they will last me a good time, that they look fantastic, and you know, in person it lets see my skin and just perfects my skin. So anyhow, my friends, let's just start with the first one, and this will be of no, I don't think, any surprise to you, because this foundation, since I started my channel, I was very clear, this is my try and truth, kind of my holy grail foundation. A foundation that looks just amazing on my skin and that I love it so much and that I trust. And this is the La Mer the Soft Fluid Longwear Foundation. Okay, so this foundation, I know it's pricey. I have bought it many, many times, but listen me out right here. I am a caterer. I do event planning and when, you know, when on a regular year, right? Not this year that has been cuckoo crazy. Usually my days are really, really extensive, really, really long. I start my journey like at 6 o'clock in the morning, 7 o'clock in the morning. I end up like perhaps at midnight, 1 o'clock in the morning out of the venue. And I really need to have a foundation to, I can really trust, and that it can actually give me that, you know, very natural finish to my skin that doesn't look like, wow, you're wearing makeup, and also that it will not emphasize my texture, my enlarged pores, my wrinkles, and my fine lines, because I mean, I just want to look as natural, as put together as possible, not thinking that I have to retouch throughout the day. And in the area that I live and where I cater at, most of the times is outdoors, like barns or just, you know, wineries, big venues, that everything is outdoorsy. So I'm like under the sun. I'm like, I have been with this foundation under 120 degrees, like that bad, sweating, dripping in sweat, and it still looks beautiful. As soon as you apply it, you will see that it has a little bit of like a satin finish, like, and it just remains like that throughout the day, but yet it gets to look more like your skin is perfected. And it comes in various different shades. I think the last time that I saw was 35 shades, but I think they actually just added a few more shades. And by the way, I will be leaving all the shades of each of these foundations on my description down below, along with other foundation matches, so that way if you are wondering, okay, I use this one right here, what will be my best match, I hope it serves some help. I also have a light to medium skin tone, just to let you know. And yes, anyhow, this foundation is beautiful. This foundation also has an SPF of 20. And I, you know, like, because of the type of job that I do, I get photographed quite a bit, you know, on the job, doing a staff, you know, with the bride, whatever it is, I appear in photos. And honestly, it doesn't have flashback. It doesn't look bad at all. It looks really beautiful. It looks like a skin light. It works super easy. It doesn't break me out. That's super important for me because I do have very, very sensitive skin. Now, a foundation that I just tried, but this foundation has been in the market for many years, and it's actually used usually on a stage, like for movies. So usually when you see movies and you see an actress, an actor, you don't see them wearing a ton of foundation unless, you know, the role plays with it. But usually you see them kind of like, doesn't look like they have much foundation. Well, guess what? One of the main products that they use is a Coach Rondeau foundation, and this is called the My Fancy Moisture Foundation. Now, they have reformulated it, and wow, if this is a natural, beautiful foundation. When you apply it, it's thick. It's really thick, and you're gonna be like, oh my gosh, this is gonna give me so much coverage. It's gonna start looking cakey on me. It's gonna pile up on places. Not at all. It blends super easy, and it managed to make your skin look perfected. Now, this foundation doesn't have any fragrance, like for example, La Mer has fragrance, but the fragrance from the La Mer is more from their proprietary ingredients, those algae ingredients. If you're used to La Mer, or if you have smell the La Mer cream, that's how it smells. You know, it's not super strong. It's nothing that is offensive, and it actually, you know, dissipates. Anyhow, going back to the Coach Rondeau one, this one is fragrance-free, paraben-free, gluten-free. I mean, it's free of so many things. Doesn't have any alcohol in it. Now, it doesn't come in too many shades. In fact, I have right here the shade 143. I also have in another Coach Rondeau foundation, the Aqua foundation, the 123, and that's too light for me. So I think I'm gonna end up getting a second bottle in 123 and keep this 143 and kind of like mix it in for just the perfect, you know, tone. That's the only caveat that I see on it, but other than that, it's really beautiful. Now, doesn't come a lot on these little mini, you know, it's not that it's mini, but it's a very small amount of product that you receive right here. But the good thing is that you don't need that much to achieve that beautiful natural coverage. And another thing that I love is also how beautiful it lasts throughout the day. I mean, if you have an 8-hour shift, even like a 10-hour, you know, time frame that you want to look perfected, this will give it to you. Honestly, a lovely, lovely foundation. The next foundation, this one I just tried. I actually made my first block of mask video of this year, and I spoke about the things that Michelle One made me buy. And one of them was this one, the Surah Dewdrop Foundation. And oh my goodness, if she was right about this foundation. This foundation, it has more of a liquidy consistency, serum-like or gel-like, I should say. It goes super smooth. It does have coverage. Now, the coverage is more into the light coverage, almost to medium, but you can build it up. It looks glorious. It does have a little bit of a glow, but as it sets down, it actually, you know, it just sets down so beautifully that it actually looks like a skin light. It gives that, you know, that beautiful sheen to the skin, kind of like that satiny finish, but it's not extremely glowy. I mean, it just works wonderful. I was so impressed on how long it lasts throughout the day, how beautiful it looks. I really dislike when foundations emphasize my enlarged pores. These ones right here, this one didn't. It just looked extremely lovely. In fact, I'm just more curious to try Surah brand because I haven't tried it. This is actually my first product from Surah, and I'm just so in love with this foundation. You don't need a lot, you know. I will highly suggest perhaps use a brush to apply it just to get the most coverage out of it. But if you're a person that do not have discoloration, freckles like mine, you know, you can definitely use a sponge. Such a gorgeous foundation, and honestly, I don't think it has any scent, or at least I haven't noticed any scent, but it's a stunning foundation. My next pick right here is the Pat McGrath Skin Fetish Sublime Perfection Foundation. This foundation comes actually in various different shades, and I will have to say that when I tried it last year, it was kind of like hard for me to comprehend, you know, the amount of coverage that it had, if I could build it up or not. Honestly, it's another foundation that I feel is meant to be used kind of like a stage-like foundation, kind of like the Cushion Doe. The Cushion Doe is thick. This one right here is more gel-like, more, even it has a little bit of sheerness to it. I couldn't find a lot of, you know, coverage as soon as I applied it. But then as it melts in and, you know, like it mixing with your oils and throughout the day, it just becomes a very beautiful foundation. I mean, honestly, it perfects the skin. It doesn't emphasize enlarged pores, fine lines. It has a long-lasting power that is beautiful, and it's very manageable. Like, you can use a type of glowy primer to give a little bit more glow to it, or a little bit of a mattifying primer. I mean, it's very, it's a foundation that is so workable and just so beautiful, and you can achieve a true medium coverage if you build it up a little, but I think that will take away from how natural it looks when just applied by itself. I mean, like, it's just stunning foundation. It has a good longevity, and I truly think it's just gorgeous. And it, like I said, it comes in so many different shades. Although a lot of people think that this foundation is very expensive, like, not as expensive as other foundations that I have right here. So to me, this foundation is truly worth the money. It makes your skin look so beautiful. And another thing that is kind of contradicting, it does have alcohol in it, but it really helps at making it set like right away. So you don't really need to wait too much until it sets. So I will say work it like by sections on your face and you will be just fine. Beautiful, beautiful foundation. And then the last foundation that I'm gonna talk about, do not hate me please, this is the new Chanel Sublimage Les Essences du Teinte. This foundation is the one that I'm wearing right now. It's unlike to anything else that I have on my collection. It does have that serum consistency. It does have a lot of skincare benefits in it. And it just applied so beautifully. It actually makes your skin look super healthy. There's no really too much glow to it. Now, very important factor right here, this foundation doesn't set by itself. So I think this foundation is beautiful when you wear it with some cream products or you otherwise have to set it. I think it has such a beautiful coverage, and the way that it just, you know, sheers out throughout the day, it just makes it look natural. It doesn't look cakey. You don't look that you're having makeup on. Honestly, it just looks so fantastic, so beautiful. And it does have a fragrance. It's that fragrance from the Sublimage line, but it just dissipates. It goes away and it's not there anymore, yet it feels so comfortable. I mean, your face feels like, you know, you can move and you don't feel like you have something, you know, on your face. It's just glorious, it's extraordinary. The only thing right here, it only seems like it's gonna come in 12 shades. It's right now available at Harrods. I will be leaving all the details on the description box below. Again, links where to find these products and whatnot. But I know it's coming to United States soon. Again, the only thing, it has only 12 shades, and that leads me to say, if you're looking for a really nice Chanel foundation, but that you have, you know, like, most likely a perfect match because this other foundation has 40 shades to offer, I will say go with that Le Beige foundation. This one right here has just a little bit more glow to it, ideal for those of us that we have dry skin, but still very natural. I mean, like, when you put it on, it's again, you know, like, it has more consistency than this one right here. It does have a little bit of translucency. It's not sheer. It's a very light to medium coverage. You can build it. It looks really beautiful, but it dries a little bit more, how do I say it? It's not matte, but it's just very natural, a very natural finish. This one perhaps is a little bit more satin. This one has a natural finish with a dash of radiance. Yes, I mean, Chanel is really coming out with great foundations right here. Okay, my friends, I think this makes it for this video. I would love to know from you, what is that foundation that you feel it gives you the most natural finish, that you feel like when you wear it, you feel like, okay, it doesn't look like, yes, you are wearing makeup. I would love to hear from you. And while you're at it, and if you haven't done so yet, I hope that you will give me that opportunity and go ahead and subscribe to my channel. Make sure you ring that post notification bell so you don't miss any of my uploads. Right now, we're in the middle of Vlogmas and I will love your company. I'm so grateful for that. So, so very grateful. Also, if you have a little bit of a time, I would love if you can come and follow me on my Instagram so we can stay connected through there. If you like this video, do not forget to give it a thumbs up, also share with family and friends, and until the next time, I hope you have a beautiful, wonderful day. Bye bye.